What example? One, one, two, two. No, no, on infinite set. On infinite set. X, Y, and Z. What's that? What is this transitive? X less than Y, Y less than Z, implying X less than Z. It's transitive. And the relation is reflexive, but neither symmetric nor normal. On Z.
But 1, 6 doesn't belong to R. As
1 minus 6 is what? Minus 5.
Okay. So it's not, so it's not symmetric.
R is not symmetric. Next, you try to show that R is not transitive. Okay, transitive now. R is not transitive. Right? You have to find three elements such that AB, BC belongs to R, but AC is not there. Try for them. AB, BC is in R, but AC is not there. Can you find such an element?
Let us check. We are not sure whether it's transitive or not.
Huh? 11 and 6. Okay. So R is not transitive. 11, 6 and 6, okay. 11 minus 6 is 5. Okay. So it's there in the relation. 6 minus 1 is 5. This is also there in the relation. Okay. So they belong to R, but what about 11 and 1? 11, 1 doesn't belong. Okay. 11, 1, this doesn't belong to R. Why? Because their difference is 10. Okay. If the difference is 5 or 0, only then it will belong. Otherwise, it will not belong. So, but 11, 1 doesn't belong to R as 11 minus 1 is what? 10. Right. So, 10 is not equal to 0 or 5. Isn't it? So, we have just modified this equivalence relation for a new relation, okay, which is reflexive but neither symmetric nor transitive. Okay. Now let us add another thing here. Number two is reflexive symmetric. Ekta condition ami include korbo. Reflexive symmetric. Okay, it has to be reflexive symmetric. Okay, but not transitive. Now, reflexive, also symmetric also, but not transitive. So, how can you modify this? How can you modify this so that this is not symmetric? Why? Okay, why this is not symmetric? Because A minus B and B minus A, they become negative. One is the negative of the other. Yeah, since I will include minus 5 also. I can write it as this. Modulus. Modulus of this is 0. In that case, it will become symmetric. Because mod of A minus B will be same as mod of B minus A. Because same as. So, this is already in class. So, you can prove it very easily as R is reflexive as mod of A minus A is 0 for all A inside. R is symmetric as AB belongs to R implies this implies what? Mod of A minus B is 0 or 5. Okay, but mod of A minus B is same as B minus A. So B minus A is 0 or 5. Okay, both are same thing. That means B, A belongs to R. Okay. So R is symmetric. But R is not transitive. This same example will work. The same example will work. 11, 1, 11, 6, and 6, 1. Okay. So you can take your own examples. No problem. You write your roll number. Yes. You can take 5 minus 4. Okay. 1, 5, 3, 4. You take 1, 5, 2, 9. Okay, this. And then 1, 5, 2, 9. From that you subtract another 5. This will also work. Okay. This difference is 5, this difference is 5, but this difference is 10. Okay. So it's not it is not symmetric. Sorry, it is not transitive. Okay. So any example you can take. So reflexive, symmetric, okay. Now I'll change it. Reflexive, transitive. Reflexive, transitive. So, how many examples we want? reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Okay. How many examples we have done physics nicely or computer, then you can understand. Or mathematics. What are examples again? This is one, not reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. Then this one. Okay, 0 0 0 0 1 0, then 0 0 1 0 1, then 0 1 0, like that. Okay, so for each there are two possibilities, so 2 cube, no? 2 into 2, 2 possibilities for this, 2 possibilities for this, 2 possibilities for this. Okay, so there are 8 possibilities. Okay, all those 8 possibilities we use, right? So reflexive, transitive, but not symmetric.
Then
the number is equal to itself. Okay, A is equal to A. So this implies A comma A belongs to A comma A belongs to R. Okay, so this R is the relation. So R is reflexive, okay. But it is not symmetric. This reflection is R. So let us check for transitive. R is transitive. R is transitive. Why R is transitive? So let A, B, C belongs to R such that AB belongs to AB and BC. Okay, and the ordered pairs belong to R. The relation. Okay. This is the set, this is the relation. So this means that A is less than or equal to B and B is less than or equal to C. So these are just properties of inequality. A less than or equal to B implies B minus A is positive, greater than or equal to C. And B is less than or equal to C implies C minus B is greater than or equal to C. Okay, if you add them, you will get C minus A greater than C. Okay, so this is exactly how we do. So this means B minus A is greater than or equal to 0 and C minus B is greater than or equal to 2. So if you add two non-negative quantities, you will get B minus A plus C minus B. This is greater than 2. So this B will get cancelled. So C minus A is greater than or equal to 2. This implies A is less than or equal to C. That is, AC belongs to C. You can write it directly also. Just properties of inequality. Okay. A less than B, B less than C, mane A is less than C. Next, you have to show that it's not symmetric. So, what is the example? Any example, sir? Not symmetric.
One.
So, 1, 2 belongs to R. As that's why 1 is less than 2. Okay. But 2,1 doesn't belong. 2,1, this doesn't belong to R. As 2 is not less than 1. Okay. So this is not symmetric. Okay, so we have done reflexive transitive but not symmetric. Done. So let us see another one. Can you give an example of this? Not reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. On the set Z. On Z. Give one example. Neither reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. A equal to B square. This one. Say R on Z defined by AB belongs to R if and if A equal to B square. So is it reflexive? It's not reflexive because the 2,2 it doesn't belong to R. Okay, because 2 is not equal to B square. So it's not reflexive. It's not symmetric. Why? Not symmetric because say 9,3 belongs to R, but 3,9 this doesn't belong. So, and it is not transitive. It is not transitive. Why? Just you take another square here. Say 29 square is 81. 81,9 and 9,3 belong to R, but 81 and 3 this doesn't belong. Okay. So this is a nice example. A equal to B square. Okay. You can also take this example, the example that we had taken earlier, A minus B equal to 0 or 5, 0 does or 5. Just take A minus B equal to 5. Okay. So in that case, it is not reflexive. Okay. Because A minus A is 0, not 5. Okay. It is not reflexive, not symmetric, not transitive. Okay. So this example also we have done. Okay. So if you complete it. Then next example is neither reflexive nor symmetric but transitive. What is this example? Become simple example. Just similar to this. M minus B?
Or equal to 10.
How? This will not work. Because if you take something like 50 and 40, and then you take 40 and 50 minus 30 is 20. So on the one you are 20 or is it? But if you take 20, if you take 30, 30, 40, 50, everything. Yeah, so this will not work here. Simpler example is A is strictly less than. Okay. Strictly less. So just symmetry here you can reflect over. There you go.
Transitive one. It's not transitive.
So try something else. Symmetric transitive but not reflexed. A comma B belongs to R, such that we not equal to the K which of the one either one. Make something from here. A not equal to B plus 1. Okay. Let us try this also. A not equal to B plus 1. It has symmetric equivalent. Two is not equal to reflexive. Order reflexive. A is always equal to A. A is not equal to A plus. This will become reflexive. So
and
this is not wrong.
Maybe A is not equal to B or A not equal to B plus 1.
A not equal to B or so in that case also if you include or then in that case also this is satisfied. So if any one of them is satisfied, it means the condition is A not equal to B and A not equal to B plus 1. Even then it's reflexive. All work, no. Okay. A not equal to B, A not equal to B plus 1. Tokon to it reflexive. The 2,2. 2 is not equal to 2. Okay. And 2 is not equal to okay. One of them is both are satisfied. Okay. So it's not reflexive. 2,2, it doesn't belong to this relation because 2 not equal to 2 is incorrect. So actually this is not reflexive. Okay. Reflexive na. Next let us check symmetric or not. If 5,4 is it inside this relation? A not equal to B and A not equal to B plus 1. Is 5,4 inside this?
No, sir.
No, it's not this. Okay. 5,3. Okay, let us try this. 5,3. This is also not there inside this relation. No? Because which element will be there? Give me one element which is there inside this. 5,3 is inside this. Yeah. Then 3,5 is also there. Okay. 5,3, 3,5 both are there. Okay. But in that case 5,5 has to be there. But 5,5 is not there. So it's not transitive. Transitive one. Okay. Which of the key I go? A not equal to B, you try modifying something like this. Say if and only if A minus B not equal to 0. So this is not working. This one is not working. Try with plus A plus B not equal to 0. Which are one for money? A plus B not equal to 0. If I write A plus B not equal to 0, is it going to be reflexive or not?
Sir, A plus B equal to 0 to the
A plus B equal to 0. Okay. A plus B equal to 0, if I take, then it's not reflexive. Because if you take A to be a non-zero element, so it's not reflexive. Okay. Then, but is it symmetric? A plus B equal to 0 will imply that B plus A equal to 0. So it's symmetric. The symmetric aspect. Okay. But is it transitive? That's what you have to check. A plus B equal to 0. A plus B equal to 0 means actually A equal to minus B. And B plus C equal to 0 means that B equal to minus C. C equal to minus B. That means A should be equal to C. Okay. So whether and that A equal to C, it's always inside. If I start with a random AB and BC inside R, and then this will imply that B a plus b is 0 and b plus c is 0. So this will actually mean that a is equal to c. And a equal to c doesn't imply that
a plus c. A minus c equal to c.
Acha, is it reflexive? Oh yeah, we don't want to be reflexive here. So from here, can I write AC belongs to R?
No,
it's not necessary. Because say 1, 1, A and C may be 1, 1. So if I start with 1, 1, okay, then 1, 1 is not an element in R. So it's not transitive.
Yeah, not
transitive. The class A or not? You take multiplication. A cross B not equal to 0. Achha, equal to 0 the other
here.
Equal to 0 it's not reflexive. It's symmetric. Symmetric as well. AB equal to 0 implies BA equal to 0. Okay. Then, what about transitive? Transitive way would be A into B equal to 0 and B into A equal to B into C equal to 0. Does it imply that AC is 0? Can I write it this way? AB is 0, BC is 0. Can I write BC is also 0? It's not necessary. No? A 2 into 0 is 0. 0 into 5 is also 0, but 2 into 5, this is non-zero. Okay, so it's not transitive. Equal to 0 there or not? Not equal to 0 there, right? Try with AB not equal to 0. And then AB not equal to 0. Product not equal to 0. Silent? Is it reflexive? If I take any A in Z, A into A is what? A square. So is it always non-zero?
Yes, sir, always non-zero.
Always non-zero, right? There is one case where it is 0. If A is 0, so 0 is not related to this thing. Okay, 0, 0 doesn't belong to that. So it's not reflexive. Okay, for every other element, it's correct. Okay. For every other element of this type, belongs to this relation. Okay, but 0, 0 doesn't mean. So that means this relation is not reflexive. Okay. Is it symmetric? A into B is non-zero implies B into A is non-zero. Okay, because they are the same thing. Now I have to check whether it is transitive or not. AB not equal to 0 and BC not equal to 0. Okay. From here, can I write AC non-zero? This can be written. A into B, product is non-zero, that means A and B are both non-zero. B, C is non-zero, so B and C are both non-zero. So that means A and C are both non-zero. So we are working on the set of integers. So the product is zero only when at least one of them is zero. So product is non-zero means both are non-zero. So A and B, B not equal to zero implies what? A not equal to zero, B not equal to zero. And BC not equal to 0 means B not equal to 0 and C not equal to 0. Okay, so this means that AC is non-zero. So AC belongs to R. Okay, so this is an example of symmetric, transitive, but not reflexive. Okay. There are other examples you can find. Okay, so one homework I am trying to give you to try this, check whether the following relation is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. The relation R on the set of say natural elements, on the set of natural elements, yeah, defined by this is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. So R on Z defined by A comma B belongs to R, if and only if. If and only if. A divides. Okay. This symbol is for divides. A divides.
Division operation
Division diya to check karte wala.
A by B. A by B is non-zero. You may try whether it will work or not. A by B is non-zero implies A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0. That is correct. But in that case, it will not be symmetric. Or what? No, symmetric. AB is, A by B is non-zero.
How is that?
No. A by B is non-zero means both A and B has to be non-zero. So B by A is also well defined. So A by B is zero. That is also correct. B non-zero, not equal to 0. So this type of elements will not be there in the relation. Non-zero. This type of elements will not be there in the relation because A by B is not defined. For a relation, I don't require that every element should have some pre-mutual again. So on that. This type of elements will not be there. 1-0 type of elements, 2-0 type of elements, this type of elements will not be there. Okay. These elements do not belong to the relation. Okay. Relation for which A by B is defined. Okay. Only those type of things will be. Suppose 1 by 2, 2 by 1, okay, those things will be. So we don't have to remove 0. A and B are related only when A by B is non-zero. Okay. So under what condition A by B is defined? If B is non-zero. No element will be related to 0. Okay. No element will be related to 0. Whether it's there. Check whether this relation A divides B. Okay. What is the meaning of A divides B? A divides B when B can be written as some K into A. Okay. Where K is a natural number. A belongs to natural number. Okay. B is divisible by A. Okay. So try to show whether it is reflexive, whether it is symmetric, whether it is transitive or not. A divides B. Why?
So it's not symmetric because say 2 divides 4, but 4 doesn't divide. 4 doesn't divide. 2 divides 4, but 4 is 2. 4 doesn't divide. That is, 4 is divisible by 2, but 2 is not divisible by 4 because it's 2 is smaller. Okay? So it's not divisible. So it's not symmetric. The relation is not symmetric. Is it transitive? Transitive or one is it? Is this relation transitive? Let a comma b comma c belongs to natural number, then such that a divides b and b divides c. Then can I write a divides b? This will imply that b can be written as some k into a, and c can be written as say p into c. P into b. So again I can write this b as a into a. Okay, so it is some natural number multiplied with a. So this implies a divides b. Okay. If a divides b, b divides c, then a actually divides c. So that means r is, this means ac belongs to c belongs to r. Okay. Therefore r is transitive. This is a relation which is transitive, reflexive, but not symmetric. So lots of examples for you. Transitive, symmetric, not reflexive. Okay, that example again. Symmetric, A perpendicular to B. So that was symmetric. Is it transitive? Is A perpendicular to B? Because if A is perpendicular to B and B is perpendicular to C, okay, on the same plane, then A and C will be actually parallel. Okay, because this will be corresponding angles. Sorry, alternate angles or corresponding angles. So A will be parallel to C.
Sir, the special case is not perpendicular. Suppose X is
parallel. X is?
Under coordinate X is
parallel. Coordinate X is? The set that I defined was the set of all straight lines on a plane. Yeah. Set of all straight lines on a plane. Yeah. That's what. So even in three dimensions, this cannot be true. Okay. If this is perpendicular to this, this is perpendicular to this, okay, and this may be perpendicular to that. Okay. On three dimensions also, it is not true. Okay. If A is perpendicular to B and B is perpendicular to C, it may happen that C is not perpendicular to A. Okay. So in the special case for XYZ axis, that is true. Okay, but if I want to say this is less transitive, it should be true for any arbitrary lines. Okay, that is not true. So on the plane, if this happens, then A and C become parallel. Okay. So on space, they may not be parallel also. They may not be perpendicular. Okay. On space, actually, see, if you have, if two lines are not parallel on a plane, if two lines are not parallel on a plane, then what is your conclusion? They will work. They will intersect. On the same plane, if there are two lines which are not parallel to each other, then at some point they will intersect. Okay. But in space this is not true. In three dimensions this is not true. There are lines which are not parallel to one another, but they never intersect. Okay. In three dimensions this is not true. Okay. So sometimes we may be thinking that if the lines are not parallel, they will intersect. No, this is not true. They will, if they lie on the same plane, only then they will intersect. Okay. If they are on a different plane, say this is one line and this is another line. Okay. So these two are not parallel, they are not intersecting. One is going that way, another is going this way. So in space they are called skew lines. Okay. Ojay, yeh course to higher secondary, the shortest distance. We have done shortest distance between two lines. Higher secondary, three-dimensional geometry was there. Okay. So shortest distance is found out for skew lines. Lines which are not parallel to one another and they do not lie on the same plane also. Okay. So that's
So many things which are true in two dimensions, they may not be true in higher dimensions. Okay, so next class will be taken by Madam. So in our next